You're listening to My Time with God for Daily Drives, Audio Devotional, Volume 4, published by Thomas Nelson and read by Molly Stewart.
We all have busy schedules and lives, and yet we yearn for restorative time with God. That's why we've created Time with God for Daily Drives. Each day, we'll bring you a scripture passage from the popular New Century Version, along with short devotional thoughts and application points to ponder. And it's all in less than 3 minutes.
Day one is from Matthew chapter 4. Then the Spirit led Jesus into the desert to be tempted by the devil. Jesus ate nothing for 40 days and nights. After this, he was very hungry. The devil came to Jesus to tempt him, saying, "If you are the Son of God, tell these rocks to become bread." Jesus answered, "It is written in the scriptures, a person does not live by eating only bread, but by everything God says." Then the devil led Jesus to the holy city of Jerusalem and put him on a high place of the temple. The devil said, "If you are the Son of God, jump down, because it is written in the scriptures, he has put his angels in charge of you. They will catch you in their hands so that you will not hit your foot on a rock." Jesus answered him, "It also says in the scriptures, do not test the Lord your God." Then the devil led Jesus to the top of a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and all their splendor. The devil said, "If you will bow down and worship me, I will give you all these things." Jesus said to the devil, "Go away from me, Satan. It is written in the scriptures, you must worship the Lord your God and serve only him." So the devil left Jesus, and angels came and took care of him.
Have you ever wondered why Satan would bother with tempting Jesus? What could he hope to accomplish? Though Satan probably didn't understand completely how Jesus would redeem us, John's baptism of Jesus openly confirmed him as the promised Redeemer, and Satan knew it. Satan also knew from the Old Covenant what qualifications were required of a Redeemer. In ancient Israel, if a creditor threatened to take your family's land, a Redeemer could legally reclaim the land for you under three conditions. He had to be a near kin, he had to be without personal debt, and he had to satisfy your debt willingly. Satan knew the world's Redeemer had to be a kinsman of Adam, a son of man, and that he had to willingly pay for man's sin, and he had to have no sin of his own. The three temptations were Satan's attempts to disqualify Jesus as our kinsman redeemer. If Jesus had commanded stone into bread, he would no longer be living as a man. Leaping from the temple would have been undeniable proof to everyone who he was, but no willing payment for sin would have occurred on the cross. And worshiping Satan, of course, would have been sin, and thus Jesus would have become a debtor to the law. Satan failed then, but has he given up? No. He now tempts you in order to disqualify your own redemptive work in the world. You are a redeemed kinsman of all mankind. Resist the enemy and he will flee from you. Deliver Christ's redemption to the world. Day two is from Matthew chapter 14. Immediately, Jesus told his followers to get into the boat and go ahead of him across the lake. He stayed there to send the people home. After he had sent them away, he went by himself up into the hills to pray. It was late, and Jesus was there alone. By this time, the boat was already far away from land. It was being hit by waves because the wind was blowing against it. Between 3 and 6 o'clock in the morning, Jesus came to them, walking on the water. When his followers saw him walking on the water, they were afraid. They said, "It's a ghost," and cried out in fear. But Jesus quickly spoke to them, "Have courage, it is I, do not be afraid." Peter said, "Lord, if it is really you, then command me to come to you on the water." Jesus said, "Come." And Peter left the boat and walked on the water to Jesus. But when Peter saw the wind and the waves, he became afraid and began to sink. He shouted, "Lord, save me!" Immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and caught Peter. Jesus said, "Your faith is small. Why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind became calm. Then those who were in the boat worshiped Jesus and said, "Truly, you are the Son of God."
After Jesus chose the 12 apostles, they spent every moment learning from him. Imagine their admiration of his tenderness towards sick and dying people, his patience towards naysayers, the astounding wisdom he shared with them and the world. Simply witnessing the miracles of Jesus would be enough to force them to their knees in awe and wonder. In fact, prior to Peter being called to walk on the water, Jesus fed 5,000 people with a few fish and loaves of bread. You would think these 12 men would be the most ardent believers of Jesus. But they were merely men with fear and doubt in their hearts. They convinced their bodies to follow Jesus, but there were many times when they couldn't convince their hearts to believe. Do you have moments like this? The skies grow dark and ominous. The waves seem to be crashing all around you. And then you see him, Jesus. You feel his presence and you're comforted. You reach out for him, but then you begin to sink. You cry out for help and suddenly Jesus is there, holding you, asking you how you could have ever doubted. The apostles were human, and they failed in their devotion to Jesus many times before he died. But we also know they were redeemed.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.